Hello, hope you're having an amazing day. Today I want to share with you how to properly set up your collection and understanding the fields. Also, we're going to create a custom form with permissions, and this is going to be super useful if you're creating dynamic pages as well. But if you're creating some type of custom form where users submit data to the collection, this is going to be perfect for you. So let's get started. The first thing is creating your collection, okay? So we're on Wix Studio right now, but it's gonna be exactly the same thing if you're in Classic Editor. You're gonna go on the left panel, you're gonna click under CMS, you're gonna go under Collections, and then you're gonna see this button that says Create Collection. It's gonna give you three options. First one, start from scratch, create with AI, and then import from a CSV file. Again, if you already have some collection somewhere else, of course, you're going to select this one. But we're going to go from scratch because I want to explain to you every specific field and how each of them works. So that way, you know how to set it up the right way. So start from scratch, click next. This is very important. When you name your collection, if you later change your mind, the ID won't change. Okay, so keep that in mind because, for example, if I name my collection projects, okay, this is gonna stay. Once I create it, it's not gonna change. I could come back and change the collection name, but whenever you're gonna start using code like Velo, then you're gonna need this name. So for now, let's just leave it as projects, and we're just gonna leave it as multi-items and then create. Once the collection is created, it will automatically gonna set a title option for you, which is a field ID. We're gonna go over each of the field IDs that we're gonna use. For now, you wanna close this. We're gonna go on the permission settings first. So you're gonna go back here on the left panel, and then you're gonna go on collections, gonna click the three little dots and click edit settings. So this is the new version of Wix Studio, and also it's probably gonna look exactly the same if you're using Classic Editor. So this is a very new video that's gonna be useful. First thing you're gonna notice is now you have this name control item visibility, which this is gonna help you. Anytime you create an item in your collection, you can set it to automatically be visible or hidden. This is also very helpful if you create a form and you want to make sure you check the data before it goes live. So then you can have it to be automatically hidden, and then you can set it to be displayed once you approve. Okay, so for this example, because we're also going to create a custom form, let's leave it hidden. Then once we go here, we're gonna go under permissions and privacy, and it gives you three options. Show content, meaning this is to everyone. Collect content, so who can add content, and then custom. Okay, so we're just gonna go with custom. We're gonna notice that automatically the admin has all the options. That means this is the owner of the website. Items creator, this is like people that, you know, sign up in your page, and then members only, and then just the public. So first, I'm going to select all of these ones because the data, I want it to be visible to anyone. So for example, if someone is creating a listing website, this is going to be very useful. Then you're going to notice the add and update. So for this one, the creator can add, and also the members, because they're pretty much the same. And then update, I also want them to be for both of them. And then delete, also both of them. And then for everyone else, they can add, update, or delete, because this is not a public form. Unless you planning to have it as a public form, then you can select all of this. So once we have that, we can just click save. And then we're gonna go back for our collection named projects. Here we're gonna add a few of the fields that we need, okay? when we go to add fill, you're going to have this panel and it gives you a few things. Okay, text, and I'm going to explain each of them. If you're new, this is going to be very useful. If you're already a little experienced, feel free to skip this part. But again, hopefully I bring some value to you today. So whenever you use text, you can use it for drop down. So if you're collecting data, right? Let's say you have a drop down and you have multiple items, let's say categories. You have an example, jobs, you have cars, what else? Food. Let's say you have multiple categories, but you want them to be only available to select one option. You can use text whenever you're using the data. Text can also be used for phone numbers. It can be used for a paragraph. Anything that you want to add as a text can be used there. And then we're going to go over which elements can be used for text. Then we have rich text. Rich text is for a specific element. You can only use it with one type of element. Okay. So let's start with text so that way we can show you which option it can be connected to. Choose field type, right? And then right away, you're going to notice it gives you field ID here. And we're going to talk about why you see this option. So we're going to name this full name. Okay. So we have full name. We also have the field type. So these are important because whenever you, in the future, if you decide to do some type of custom code, this is going to be very, very useful. For now, we just know that this field name is full name, and the field ID, it will automatically generate it. It's all together. You can also still change it. I'll just leave it like that. Click save. Okay. When you have the code on, that's when you're gonna see a few more tools. So I'm gonna turn it off, right? So as you can see now, it's off. And if we go back to the collection and I click edit, you notice now you don't see the field ID. You only see it when the option for coding is on. So we're gonna go back, turn it back on. Start coding. Even though, let's say right now you're not coding, this is going to be very useful when we're going to start using elements under the input. This option also becomes available once you turn this on. Okay. Let's minimize this for now. We're going to go under input. And as you can see here, this type of element you'll be able to use with text. Okay. You're also going to be able to use anything that says text input, like first name, phone number, text box. All of this can be used with text. Okay. All of these ones. This one, you won't be able to use with the text field. As we scroll down, you can also use this one because this one needs a date type of field. Okay. If we keep scrolling, all of this, you're not going to be able to use it. Now, there is one exception on when you can use these elements, and that's if you're using code. So whenever you connect an element to a data set, you're forced to only use these elements. You're forced to use the elements based on the type of fields that you have. But if you're using code, you have more freedom, but you want to keep that in mind whenever you're creating your collection. We're going to go back to the collection one more time, and we're going to go and add another field. In this case, I want to add a number. Okay. Numbers usually will be just like it says right here for rating. And to organize, I wouldn't never use number for a phone number because you cannot add any parentheses or dash to separate the item. So for this one, I will still use text and I'm going to name it phone. Okay, so we're gonna name that phone, and then we're gonna add another field, and this one we can do rich text if we want the user to be able to add some type to hyperlinks, and this is gonna be in a paragraph format. So I wouldn't use it if you're just using it for a link or something like that. If you wanna add links or buttons or email, you can use the URL. Okay, so let's say they wanna add their website or their social media profile, then I'll use URL. And this one, I can just do Facebook for example. Actually, let's do TikTok. Okay, so we're gonna save it. Now we have our field ID there. We're gonna add another one, which is gonna be, again, number. This one, we're gonna name it rating, okay? And then we can use this one for the future if you wanna have some type of rating option for the user. Then we're gonna add a new field, and this is gonna be for tags. Now, rich content, I wouldn't use it if you're having users submit data to the form, because it gets very, very complex. So I will stay away from this. You can still do pretty much everything with all the other elements. So keep that in mind. So we're gonna use tags, and we're gonna name it something like favorite food. No, what we can do for tags? Because we're doing projects. Okay, we can do types of projects. Okay, so we're naming these projects, but it's gonna be an owner that has contact information, phone number, social media, ratings, and type of projects using tags. Then we're gonna use another element, which is Boolean. Boolean usually is just for yes or no, and is very specific for the type of element that can be connected. So we're just gonna add it as like a new project and then save. So we're gonna go over these two. The type of element that it's tags can only be used with these two type of elements, okay? You cannot connect it with anything other. The tags can only be connected here. If you're using a data set. So whenever you're using the data set, you can only connect it to tags. One thing, again, an exception is if you're not using a data set and we're just using straight code, then you don't have to worry about that. But in the event that you're planning to connect it to a data set, then you're gonna be forced to only use a field type named tags. Okay, so now we're gonna do another one, which is gonna be reference. For reference collections, is if you're working with multiple collections, this is very useful if you already have another collection, let's say name projects by type, right? So you have a specific type, or if you have a members collection that you wanna reference. So this is where you're gonna use it. You can also use multi-reference if you have multiple collections, not just one. So for this example, we're just not gonna use this one today, and then we're gonna move to the next one. So we're gonna add image. Whenever you add an image, this is for a single image or photo. And again, you can, for example, on this one, we can name it profile picture. And then it's a field type image, and then save. That one can only be connected with a field type image, like one of this. You cannot connect it to a gallery because it has multiple elements, so it won't even let you. So keep that in mind. We're gonna go back to projects. And then we're gonna add a gallery. So the gallery allows you to add multiple images and can only be connected to a gallery type of element. So here we can do all project images and then save. And then we're going to continue to the next field. The next one is going to be video. This is if you want to upload your own video to your website, or if you want users to upload their own video. One thing I would usually not recommend doing the video option, because there might be people that have videos that are very heavy or very long that might take them forever to upload, and then you can run into issues, run out of space really quick. So what I normally do is I use the URL, and then we can just do video one in case I'm planning to add multiple videos, and that way I can have them upload or submit a video link from, let's say, YouTube or in video or some any other platform where they just have the link, and we can still make this video visible on the website as a link, and I'll show you how. So for this type of element, the video, the type of element with the URL that you can use is the text input. Whenever they're submitting data, this is the one that we can use. And then we're gonna go back to the projects again, collection, and then we're gonna add another field. So we're gonna use the audio here. This is specifically just for music. Another example is like video. It has to be an MP3 file or some type of music file to be able to upload it. Documents, same thing. This is only for PDFs, Word, Excel, those type of files. And then if you plan to upload multiple documents, then you can use any of those. So let's do document. And then we can just do it as bio, just as an example. And then for this type of element, you're going to use a button that it's right here under upload buttons. So you can use any of these two. Okay. So if I select this item, I can also go on the settings and select that it's going to be document, video, image and video, and audio. So this, by doing this selection, it will also allow me to prevent people to upload, trying to upload something that doesn't belong to this type of file. So I can set it to document and then just make sure name upload PDF file and then upload up to one file. Because we select only the option for one file. So let's go here. And then if we gotta do change type, let's say I wanna upload multiple documents, then I'll use this one. So for now, we're gonna leave it like that. And we're gonna go to add the next field. On the next one, we're gonna do date. And then this could be something like submission date and then save, and then we're gonna add another field. This one can be time, we can be like time submitted, and then save. And then we're gonna also, for these two types of elements, you're going to be able to use, where it go? It's this one right here. I just saw it. Okay, here. So this is the time picker and then date. So you can use any of these ones for those type of elements. I'm going to go back to the projects. We're going to go into add a new field. And then here we have address. So for address, we can just leave it as like our location. And then save, then close. So that one can only be used with this element right here, address inputs. So any of these three. So pretty much we're almost done. The last element here that I like to use a lot is object. This one will be used if, for example, you have you want to add all those elements in one place, and then retrieving it is also just using a text. So this is more for like when you're using code. And again, it's really fun once you start using it because it can save you a lot of time. I'm going to show you an example right now of what does it look like. So let me open it here really quick. Okay, so in this example right here, if we go here into, I want to see if I can just log in really quick. And it's going to be worth it, okay? So just bear with me a second. So I haven't logged in a while. And to find my collections. Okay, members. Okay, I'm gonna use. This one. Okay, so on this example, right, if I go here to this element, okay, so as you can see, there's a price here. I'm going to add three products, add the order. And then once I'm here, you're going to notice I have a price, I have a number of items, and this also has a different price and a different element. And then I have a total and I place the order, right? So this is a really good example of all this data. Instead of having to add each of the elements up here, like the fields. So instead of having to add each of these, I'll just add as an object and it will put all this data there in one place. So it saves you a lot of space and also a lot of time, but mostly it's going to be when you're using code. So that's something that it's really cool to use. So again, this is the object. So for now, we have all our elements, so we can start working on our form. Let's go into the next one. Okay, so now we're gonna start setting up our collection. I'm gonna delete all of these elements just because we're gonna start from scratch here. The first thing I like to do to keep myself having an easier way to work, this is just a tip that I will give you. I'll go in, open a new tab, go to the CMS, and then I'll open my collection. So that way I can see all the fields I have. And I'll just move it to a different screen that I have here on the side. And again, this is super useful. But again, it's totally up to you how you'd like to work. Let's go here. Okay. So we're going to start with adding our first element, which is going to be the full name. So I'll add my element right here. Normally, I like to, even though I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing code or not, I have this habit of already naming my elements. Just in case that later I decide to use some code, it makes it much easier. So I'll just leave input and then I'll do, for example, full name. And here on the ID, you don't need spaces. So we're going to go under settings. We're going to change this to full name. And then right here, we can just also do full name. And we have our element right there. Normally, you can also just duplicate this one because the next one is going to be phone. And you can just duplicate it if you already have this, the size text and everything there. Or you can just go back here and add another one and do all the changes that we just did right now. So whatever it's easier for you. Again, this part is just whatever you prefer. I like to just duplicate this because I already have some things. I'm going to change this to phone. And then here I'll do an example of what I want the phone to look like. And then we're going to do four right there. So that way the user see what how the phone needs to be set. Many times people don't do it, but at least most of them will see the example of like, okay, that's how I supposed to put the number. But it's totally how you want it to be. And then I'll also add leave input there and then just add font after that. The next one we need is the TikTok link, right? So let me expand this one more time. We're going to now duplicate this and we're going to add the URL. And then we can just name it TikTok URL. And then here I can just add HTTPS. Because I want them to know how this is gonna, how they need to add their URL, and then we can just leave it like that. Oh, so we have those. Then we need rating. This is, for example, something that you can use later, but for rating, you can use any of these elements right here. For this example, let's just add it, maybe something that you need. And then under settings, let's say I want to hide the value. And I also want to show just the number of ratings right here, right? In this case, you don't need it because this is going to be a submission form. So you can add it right there. I'm going to select all of the elements so I can drag them. And let's say on this one, I want to add some, where is it here? I want it to be center. The size is a little bit bigger. And then you can even add a text on top to kind of say like, rate our service or something, right? So let's just do it right there. And then right there. Then we need the type of projects. So we can go here onto the input and then go under our tags. So I can just use this one. One thing about using this element right now, because it's going to be a form, I'm just adding this so we can have extra space. One of the reasons why, organize this really quick. One of the reasons that you want to use something like this is because it's very easy to select options. But also, as I mentioned before, because we're going to use the data set, you're limited for the type of elements that you can use. But if you were to use code in this case, you could even use something like this and just separate it with commas and you'll be able to add the tags in the collection. But for this one, we're just going to leave it like this. Click manage choice and then you can just delete all the options that are already here. And then we can add our own. So we're going to change this to project one. And then I can just copy this. the value is what is actually going to go into the collection, not the label. So make sure to keep that in mind, that whenever you add it, see where it says breakfast, that's something that the user see, but the actual name that's going to go in the collection is project one, which is the value. But let's say I want to just match everything and put project one in the top. So I will do it like that. I'll do project two. And then I'll edit the label and do two right there. Just to save us time, we're just going to leave two tags right there. And then just leave it right there. Then projects. Okay. Type of projects. Then we're going to do the Boolean. The Boolean also is going to work like this. So we're going to use any of this, which is yes or no. So we can just use it at the end for new project. And then we can set it, or you can also set it to agree terms of service. So I can just hide the link and then just say, this is this a new project. And then they all select yes or no. Then we're going to also add a profile image. So we're going to use the button right here under input. We're going to go to upload buttons. And we're going to use this one right here. And then we're going to name this profile picture. And we can set it to just one and image right here. Then we can also expand this. I'll duplicate this because the next one is going to be old projects. So this is going to be right there. And then this one is going to be image and video because I want them to be able to upload multiple items. So this is going to be upload gallery. And then I want to set the max number of files that they can upload to 10. Okay. And then I can say here, upload up to 10 photos. So that way they know. Then I need to add a video. So this one I can also duplicate. Okay. Or you can just go back here, go to input, and just grab a text, whichever is easier for you. You can also just grab the text. Let me delete that so that way you'll see that you don't have to just duplicate, but it's just saving you time. And then right here, it's going to be video. And then here, add your URL video. That's it. Then we're also going to need to add a submission date. So we're going to go here, going to go to date, select a date, and then right there. And then on this one, we don't need to do anything. We just have it like that. Or you can just, again, time submit it like that. And then we need also time. So we're going to go to time. And then I can also set how I want the time format, drop down, something like that. And then here, time submitted. And then we'll scroll this one more time. And then we're going to add our location. So if I go here under input, find location. And then we're just going to do our location. Now, the other thing is we're not aligning anything because we're just like going to show the functionality of this. And that's why you don't need to align it right now or worry about that part. We're going to add one more thing, which is the button. And the button is what is going to submit the data. Okay. So we have our submission form. So I'm going to show you two ways. Okay. We're going to do one with the data set. And then we're going to do one just using code. So let's start with the option with adding code. So we're going to go add data set. We're going to select our collection right here, just projects, and then I can name it something like projects form. And here you can do a space form data set. And then create. So now it's going to show right here. Then as you can see right here, you go onto data settings. So let's go back here, data set settings. And the ID is data set one, but I will just change it to projects form data set. And on the ID needs to be all together. Read, write, or read and write. These options are depending on what you're planning to do with this form. If you want just a user to upload data, then you're just going to have it as write. If you're planning the user to add data, but also being able to update it, you have to add read and write. Now, when you use read and write, if it's a new user, the form is going to look unavailable. So we're going to use these two so I can show you what it looks like. So let's start first with write. We go here. First, I'm going to select my data set, projects form, and then this one can go to rating. Then right here on full name, same thing, projects, and then full name. Phone number, gonna be phone, TikTok URL, projects data set, and then it's gonna be TikTok URL. Then we have our tags. Because this is a form, we're going to select collect. If you were using a type of search, then you will use filter. So for this example, we're going to use collect. And then we're going to use projects form. And then we're going to leave it like that. If I do tag values connected to, let's say if I were to use some other collection and then using reference collections, then I'll use this one. But in this case, because the options are here on the same element, then I don't have to worry about this. I'm going to go to the next option, which is also collect data set, and then it's going to be Boolean. The upload photo is going to be projects form. And then this is going to be profile picture. Then this one is going to be projects data set. And this is going to be gallery. So if we go to media gallery, it's right there. Video URL, projects. And then this is going to be video URL. Then time submitted. We're going to use projects data set, submission date. And as you can see right away, everything is grayed out because you're not going to be able to connect this element with anything else. And that's what I mentioned earlier. If you're using a data set, you're limited to only using the elements available with the field type that is similar or compatible, sorry. And if not, then you can use code to have a little bit more freedom. The next one is going to be time submitted. And the last one is projects form. And then our location. And I did forget one item, which it was the document. We're going to add one more button under input. And we're going to go to upload buttons. I'm going to use this one. And this is going to be a document. So I want to make sure go to under settings, document. It's a single document, and I can just name it here. Upload your document. PDF, Excel, other. Okay. And then I can connect it to bio. And then last one, we're going to connect the button to submit. And has to be submit. Then we're going to select these two options, success message. When you add it, sometimes it puts it all the way at the top. So make sure you find it. And then you can just put it under the button. These ones are kind of like hidden. So they don't display unless you have successfully submitted data. So we're going to go back here. And then the failure one also. We're going to put it right there. So again, these only show depending on what happens, but they will never show at the same time. So that's why a lot of the times I'll just put them on top of each other just to save space. But it doesn't matter because they're going to only work that way. So we have pretty much successfully created our form. Now let's test it. So I'm going to click publish. And I'm going to go to close this window. Make sure I have a login option right here, because the way I set up the permissions on the collection, if you remember, it was using a, what do you call it? It was using a only members or creators only. I'm gonna add my page right here. I think I name it new. And then publish. There's our page right there. So again, right now, if I try to submit it, it's going to give me an error because I have it set. See, the error's right there. I have it set to only members, so I'll have to create an account. So let's sign up. Use this fake account. And then now I logged in. I can just add, for example, 40A. I can paste my link here. I can select both. All of those. I have that. Select the date, time. And then select that. And then I can upload a document. And then upload, and then I can click get started. So as you can see, now we got submitted. We got the success message. Again, right now it looks all messed up because we're not organizing that. But the most important part is making sure that this form is working. So if we go to the projects, it's right there. So it submitted everything except the type of projects, the rating. So we're gonna look into why that didn't work. But everything else is there. And then we're going to also create a dynamic page to display all this data. So first, let's take a look at this. This is a rating display. Okay, so to start, I picked the wrong element. So we're going to delete that one. We're going to go back to input. And then we're going to go to, we were on display rating. But what we actually wanted is add rating. So that was my mistake there. And then on the tags, also, I didn't connect it. So let's go to add rating first, rating. And then we're going to do projects. And then we're going to connect it. Okay. So now it's connected. So if I publish it, now I should be able to add the data. So let's go one more time, refreshing this page. And then we're going to go here. Gonna test this one more time. Demo 2. We're gonna paste our link right here. Adding those two. Upload a picture. upload a few pictures right here. Then open, paste my video URL, select the time, date, then address, and then a document, and then get started. So as you can see, it's uploading everything and it was successfully submitted. So if we go here on our form, it's right here. So now he added the rating because I gave a 5-star rating, right? And then he added the projects, this, images, the URL, the dates, and then I have also the document. So the location as well. So it's all working. Now let's create a place where we're gonna display this data. But actually I promise you that we're gonna do it also for the user to be able to edit their own data, right? So let's do that first. So when I go here, I'm gonna go under data settings. And then right now I have it as write only. So I'm gonna do read and write. But once you do that, because how are you going to know which user submitted what? Then you're going to add a filter. You're going to go here and then you're going to scroll under owner. And then the owner is logged in. So what it's doing is only going to display the data that I submitted. Okay, so this is going to be a very complex form the more we're going to work on it. Okay, so now we have an edit option. But the other problem we're going to encounter right now is that if you're a new user, so let's publish this. So we just did those changes, right? But I want to show you what's going to happen. Give it a second. Okay. First thing, we're going to go here under projects. And you're going to notice that me as a user, the system knows who I am. Because if we go under manage fields and I go under ID, where is ID here? Okay, here it is. If I make it visible, the system know that I am the same person who submitted the data, right? Because they all know to detect this thing right here. Also the ID is created by the system automatically. And right now we have, this is our main ID because we created our account. So the system already knows who I am. So if I go here now and I refresh, I should be able to see my own data. Let's see. Okay. So as you can see, I'm logged in here. And the reason why it's not showing my own data is because I just changed the setting. So I'm going to refresh one more time. Okay. So first thing is because I just changed the data, it's not knowing exactly that this is the user that belongs to this. But the second thing is you're going to notice I cannot click anything. And the reason why is because once you set the form to read and write, if the user haven't added any data or there's no data for that user, you won't be able to do anything. So we need to add a button here. Okay. So we're going to add a button. Where is the buttons here? And you can name it anything you want. So in this case, we're going to name it just add listing. Okay. And then because we're using the data set, then I'm going to connect it to new. And that's it. What is the only problem about this button now? Is that anytime I click new, it's gonna add a new item to the collection. So there's no limit. So this is why then you're gonna be required to use a little bit of code, because what we wanna do is that once we add an element, one item, we want the code to, sorry, we want the form to either stop working if I have only one item available for the user, if I don't want the user to add multiple listings and I only want them to add one. But just to show you how this works, we're going to publish this for now. We're not going to go into the code yet. We're going to refresh this. And remember, I cannot do anything, right? I cannot add any element. So I'm going to click Add Listing. And as you can see, now it's available. Now I can add data. So let's give ourselves 4, demo 4. And then I'm going to paste URL here. Select both elements, actually just one, and then upload a picture. Date. And then we're going to do that straight. And do this document and then get started. So now everything got submitted. So we're going to go back to our collection to make sure it was submitted. And as you can see here, now we have it right there. Okay. If I go back here, I should be able to see my own data. So if I refresh and then one other thing. Okay. Another thing that I totally forgot is this item right here needs to be visible. And then we can refresh. And there it is. Okay. So as you can see, without the referencing, it's already working to show you specifically the data for whoever submitted it. But as you're going to be adding more users, so I'm going to log out and I'm going to create a new account. So I'm going to do login, sign up, and we're going to do demo. And then just going to put this random password and then sign up. And then again, I'm going to add listing. I'm going to do demo. Then I can add a random number. I'm going to add a URL. Select both projects. I'm going to add this image. And then I'm going to do another one here. Then open. I'm going to add another link here. And then there. Actually, let's do 10. And then document here, open, and then get started. So one thing that when we were submitting data, you notice that we have set our project's settings to be automatically hidden unless you approve it, right? So that's why it was invisible. So as you can see now, I added this other item and then now I can make it visible. And if I go here and I refresh, I should be able to see the same data. Okay, there is, you can see it's there. So if I log out, I should be able to change this. So if I log out and I log in again, and then as you can see now, it's demo 4. So this, what do you call it? This item right here, the filter, is enough to kind of like display the data that you want without using a reference. Now, whenever you're using the reference, it's going to make it even better. But for that, you will need code. And the other problem about right now is that this button right here, if I click it one more time, now I can add data again, right? And we don't want that. So what we want to do is we want to have a code that doesn't allow to add more than one item. The code that we're going to use is this one right here. And the way it works is as follows. So let me explain. First, you're going to have your button still connected to the data set. to set to new, right? But then we're gonna use the first field ID with the input ID for full name, because this one is mandatory and you know that this will always be filled. In your case, could be an email, phone number. You can decide whatever you want it to be, but the input full name, this is the one that we have right here. So if yours is different, you can just change it. But if you want to use the same name, that's totally fine. Once we add updated on the code, the other thing that we have to keep in mind is the ID name for the button, which I have set as at least in BTN. And that one is this one right here. Also on the field ID, under projects, we're using this field ID, full name. So what the code is doing is using the project form data set, because that's where it's connected to. And this is the ID right here, right? So the button is connected. What it's doing is it's gonna look inside the field ID full name, which is what I just showed you right now, full name. And I'm sorry if I'm going back, but I just want to make sure it's clear. This one right here. So that's your field ID name, right? That we're using in this part of the code right here. So what we're saying is, like, if this element has data inside of it, then you're going to hide the button. And then if there's no data, then it's going to display. So once you copy the code, again, it's going to be on the link in the description below. You're going to click publish. And then we can test it. So as you can see right now, I have data in this for this account, and you don't see the button. So we're going to go back here in the collection. We're going to delete that item from the collection. So I'm going to delete it. So now there's no data for this user, right? So if I go back here and I click refresh, you should be able to see the button again. So the button is there. And now if I try to type anything, it won't let me. So I have to activate it. I can add the name. So let's do. And you notice as soon as I type the name, the button got deleted. And then I can just continue filling up with all my data and then submit. So once it's submitted, because I'm logged in, if I refresh, the button won't appear again. My data's still there. Now we're gonna take our form to the next level. We're also gonna add a button to delete the content on our collection, okay? And again, you can place it anywhere where you think it's better. But we're gonna add a button here. Let's use this one. Just gonna place it right there. And we're gonna change the color to red. And where is it? Red. Okay, here it is. Gonna do that red, and then we're gonna do white text inside. And then we're gonna change it to delete. Delete listing, for example. And this is also another concept. So there's two ways to doing it, right? So you have your button here. You're going to use the same data set, forms data set, and then you can click delete. And then it will automatically delete the item that's here. The only thing is that this one doesn't have a warning, because once they click the button, what it's going to do, it's going to automatically delete it. What if it was a mistake and they click on it? So you want to have a way that this button works after they already were sure that they wanted to delete something. So we can, again, take this form to the next level. We're going to add another button. And it can be same exact button. Okay. And this one, we can just leave it as yellow. And then here, we can also name it delete listing. But the only thing we're going to do is we're going to use a little bit of code. And we can just add our code here at the bottom. And delete listing. So what we're gonna do here is we're going to tell the system when someone clicks the button to change the label to are you sure you want to delete the listing. And then if they say yes, then the button will show. Or we can just have them, as soon as they click on it, then this one will appear. So let's change the ID for this one. We're going to name it delete button. And then this one is going to be delete confirmation. Also button, BTN. And now let's create our code really quick. So we have our code already, so I'm going to paste it right here. The way I create the codes is I use an AI, and I have a course that's linked on the description below if you're interested in learning how to use it. It's super easy. So as you can see here, I created the code for this button, right? And one of the things you can do here to save your space is you technically could put this one on top, or you can put it next to it, because one is always going to be hidden. So you'll never have a problem or showing or not the right one. And let me explain what the code does. So on the code right here, we have the first button, which is delete listing. And this one, actually, let's rename it to yes, because now it's supposed to be ready. Yes. Now it should be able to just delete it, right? So this button is going to be hidden, and then this one is going to show all the time. So what we're saying here is on the button, once it's clicked, it's going to change the label to are you sure? And if you don't want to say are you sure, you can change it right here. This is where you can change the label, right? And then once it does it, it's going to display or it's going to show this button right here. And then we give it a 3-second time. So if they don't make a decision in 3 seconds, then it's going to go back to normal. So I'm going to publish this so that way you can see exactly how it works. And let's go back here and refresh this. So as you can see, I have the button right here. It says delete listing. If I click on it, now it says, are you sure? Yes, delete listing. And I would click it and it's going to delete it. Now, actually, let's test it. If I click yes. Oh, and check 3 seconds. It's gone. You can increase the time, but I put it for 3 seconds. And then yes, delete. So now it deleted the listing. So if I refresh the page, you're going to notice the button should appear again. Add listing. And if we go on the collection, now it got deleted. So if we go here on the projects, there's nothing here. So, and now even if I click delete listing, the button is unavailable or disabled. So I can click again, work on this, and I can add anything, upload a picture. Again, I'm not filling out everything because I don't have it as a require. The most important one, this one, I do have a require just because I want to make sure the button works. But everything else is optional. And then once it submits the picture, now it's there. It hides the button. And now this one is available again. So that's how you make your form a little bit more complex. Or not complex, more sophisticated. So as you can see here, there it is. It gives you an error because I didn't add any link. But that's pretty much it there. So we're going to go now to the next part, which is displaying this data in a dynamic page. So our form, let's say we're happy with it. We're going to go here under collections. And then we're going to go under projects. And then I'm going to add a dynamic page. And normally I like to add, if you're having a classified type of website or listing, then I like to have a list and then an item page. For this one, I don't like any of their designs. So I'm just going to use a blank page. And then once we add this part, this is key when you're doing this part, because many times people make this mistake. And I'm going to make it on purpose so you see how to fix it. So I added my dynamic page, right? And then I'm going to add in another. So normally you'll have to fix your, if we go here under settings, you have to fix this part to make it a list. But let's say I forgot and I go here and I'm going to do add another dynamic page, because remember we need two, and then blank page, right? So I added that right there. And let's give it a second. Okay, perfect. So as you can see here, I have two, but now the names of the pages are the same. So what I want to do is I'm going to go under settings, and then I'm going to delete title, because the first one is going to be list, where I want to display all the listings from all the users. So I'll just leave it as projects. And then that makes it a list. And then this one is going to be an item. So I'm going to click settings. And then you notice, because it was the same page, but it cannot have the same URL, it added a one. You can leave it there, or if you want to keep it clean, since now you have the list here, you can just change it back to just projects. It doesn't matter, it won't affect. What does affect is this part right here, because this is what makes it a detail page. So where is it picking this from, right? It's picking it from the primary of your collection. So if you go here, this is the primary, and this is where it's getting it from, because it's set as primary. Now, once we start using other things like creating more complex type of websites, you don't want to keep it as a title for many reasons. And normally I will just leave it like that for now. But what I would normally use on this case is ID. So let's go back to the item page here. And then I'll delete title. And then I'll add ID instead. The reason why I like to add ID is for specific place, a specific type of websites. If there are there's websites that use people's names and last names, because the chances are that someone named Danny Miguel are very high. So if you have two people that have the same first name and last name, then one of the pages is not going to show. Or detail pages. So that's why this is important, that you decide how you want to do it. Now, if it's projects and you know that for sure they're not going to have, never, you're never going to have a project with the same name, then you can just use a field like full name, or even use a phone number. But of course, you don't want to be sharing that all the time. So I will use ID for that one. So we have our list and then our dynamic. So we're going to add a repeater. I'm going to go to repeaters, and I'm going to use this one. Here, I can just expand this a little bit. And then I can add a picture. So if I do this one right here, and then I can also use a title. So that way I know what it who belongs to. And then I can also make this smaller. This is too big. Let's do 16 here. And then I will add a button so I can send the user to that specific detail page. Let's say in the future you don't want to use a button because maybe you just think it looks ugly or whatever, and you want to convert the image or the text into a button, you can also, once you're connecting it to the data set, right? So if you go to projects, item, And then I go to links to, and I want to put it to projects item. So now the image becomes like a button. The text is not possible. You can only do this with a code. So you can connect it to set it up with code. So that way it will become a button. Or you can also use one of the buttons right here that's like a text type. So that way the text becomes clickable, whichever is easier for you. Normally, I just try to save time and I'll just add a button. But it depends on how your design requires it. That's how we're going to do it. And then here we're going to have it as name. And then this button, we're going to connect it also projects item. And then projects item right there. And then we're going to go now to our projects detail page. And then right here, one of the things that we're going to be using is the way of displaying the videos. Remember, I said we're going to be able to display videos. So first, let's add the profile picture. Okay, so we're going to add profile picture. What else do we have? We have full name. And then let's add full name here. Also, let's make this smaller. And then we can do full name. And then I can just duplicate this. And then I can have it as CMS, because this will be coming from the CMS. Then I also need a phone number. And then what else do we need? So we need to duplicate this. And we can just do CMS phone number. So that way you know exactly what it is. Full name. Then we need also our link for TikTok. So for that one, what I would do is I will use buttons. And then I'll use this one, for example, right here. And then I'll just change the label. So I'll go to settings, replace icon, and I can just type TikTok. If you don't have it, or if you don't have the specific ID, you can just go to Canva and then find the icon and download it as a CSV file, and then you can use it. So there it is. Go to icon right here, make it a little bigger. And then also have a video. So there's two ways on how you can do it. So we're going to do video here for this one. So let's say video. And then we can put it right there. And then on top of that, because we also have the rating, so we can add a rating here. So we're going to go under input. And then we want to display our rating right here. And for this one, I will use code to decide how to display the ratings in case, let's say, you have multiple people adding ratings to this listing or whatever. Again, this was just an example of just to be able to use the element. But in this type of project, it doesn't make sense. But then I'm going to do another video just to show how you can add ratings. For now, we're just going to hide the settings. We don't want to show the value, only the number of ratings. But again, because this is one, we're just going to leave it like that. And we also need gallery. So we're going to add a gallery. So if we go to media and I use this one, I can just place it right there. And lastly, we need a video. I know we have more elements that we can use. But again, we're trying just to use the ones that I know you're going to be trying to use. That makes it easier. So let's go and find a video. Where's a single video here? Okay, here we can use this one from YouTube. And we're going to place it right here under this part. Okay. So now we have everything that we need. We're going to connect it. So this is going to go to profile picture. This is going to go to our ratings. This is going to go to the full name. This is the email. No, phone number. Phone. Okay. Oh, we're going to also add a map because we do have address. So we can just go here. Go to, where is it? Contact maps. And then we can use this one. I think it looks cool. And where we go. Okay, there is. And then expand it. Okay, so we connected the phone, the button. Now we're going to go under connections. We want it to be TikTok. And then this one, I want it to be video URL. And then this video can also be connected to the video URL, which is right here. Where do we go? Oh, wait. Yeah, probably this one is not going to let us. Let me see. Is video source? Okay, there is. It was source, not label. Okay, so keep that in mind. So I'll click here. And the source is going to be video URL. So that way, any video that you put on the collection is going to display here. Then the gallery, of course, we got to connect it to the gallery, all media projects. And then this one is going to be connected to the address. So where is this address? Why is it doing that? Let me see. Okay, we want to go. Okay, here it is. It's because it was selecting the section. So you got to make sure you're selecting the actual element. And then we're going to go location connects to our location address. You can also do the title as the full name . And then if you have description and other stuff, you can also connect it. Now our thing is all ready. So we're going to publish this and actually, we need to add it in our menu. So it's also easy to access. And we're going to go main pages, show more pages. And we're going to go to list. Done. And then projects. There you go. We're almost there. And let's wait for it. Okay, now let's refresh this page. If we go to projects, we should be able to only see one. And if I go to the detail page, I'm missing things, right? So this doesn't have anything. The TikTok might not even work. The video neither, because there's nothing in our collection. So we're going to add it because we're logging into our account. So I want to add a URL for TikTok. So let me pull it up here on this site. I'm going to copy a link. And then we're going to paste the TikTok here. And then I'm also going to add a gallery. So open that. I'm going to add a video URL from YouTube. I'm going to use one from Mr. Beast. And then a date also. We didn't even add those, but let's just add this one and then get started, right? This button, you should change it just to submit the label. So now it's been submitted. So if we go to projects, you should be able to see the details. So I added the Mr. Beast video here. I added the gallery. And as you can see here, the label and the location is what I had. And then this should work. So see, and then here the TikTok. So that's how you're going to be able to, also this one will work for this one. It will open a link. So as you can see, it did open it. Had to close it just in case. But that's how you use the URLs for displaying videos and also social media links. But hopefully this was a very productive class or course, whatever you want to call it. If you want, again, learn how to create code, let me know or go in the description. You'll have access to the full class where I show you exactly how to create any type of code, create any customizations, and just whatever you can imagine, you can create. Thank you so much for the patience and have an amazing and blessed day.